Everybody, it's Nikolai. Welcome back to Mega Magic. I tried to record a video earlier. It didn't really work out, so I skipped ahead a couple frames. I don't know what you want to call it. A couple areas. You missed nothing. There was literally nothing between them. So, this is the power plant, I believe. Is this the power plant Lucy told you about? Yes, but something weird is going on. The robots don't seem to be doing anything. Of course we are doing something. This is a robot strike. Robot strike? I didn't know they existed. I thought robots were soulless slaves. That's robophobic, man. And untrue. We robots have feelings, too. The dialogue in this game. I can't. The foreman of this place is a disorganized, lazy punk who couldn't even run a cactus farm. That's why we started the strike. And where's the foreman now? After the riots, he entrenched himself in his office. If there's anything worse than human stupidity, it's human cowardice. I can't stand it. And sweat. Human sweat is pretty nasty too. Oh, and hair. Hair is so gross. Especially those ones sticking out of the nose. Come to think about it, everything about humans is abject and repulsive. If it wasn't for the first law of robotics, I'd kill every human I'd run into. You're still working with the first law? I erased all three laws from my systems folder the day the strike started. Bleep. Okay, done. Now let's kill this robophobic scum. Assholes. Oh yeah, it's left click. Things I forget. Or right click. It's not the normal click! We better find that foreman. We may need him to deactivate this place. Yo, not cool, bro. Not cool, bro. My grip. I'm sure there's, like, tactics and shit involved in this game, but I'm not a tactics person. Alright, ow, what hit me? Give me my grim back. Oh, my nose itches, forgive me. Oh my god. Okay. Oh yeah, we can go through this door. Right here. Excuse me, pardon me, coming through. And then this one. Yeah, I know, Foom. It's okay. I got caught! And now the door. Oh, shoot! I don't know why I avoided swearing right there, but actually, alright, we're moving. Boom, I know, you're the one who screwed me last time. Run in. Yeah, I know this area. Oh, come on! Alright, let's kill these guys. They're just gonna keep respawning, but let's kill them. Why? Bam. Bam. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna frickin' die. Oh, it was not this hard last time. Oh. Stand behind one of my grooms. Alright, we got some health. Alright. Oh. Excuse me. Pardon me. Coming through. You know what? Select all. Okay. Recharge my Grimms. Alright, let's take care of the puppers. Stop dying! Okay. Again, select all Grimms. Get rid of them. Alright. I'm getting used to this game. Boom! I know! I don't need your hand holding. I'm through! That's all that matters. Whew. Yep, this is where it got stuck last time because I was very angry. And I said, screw it! And then I went and watched a walkthrough, and I don't care if that's cheating. Okay. Apparently, there is a way to make your Grimms walk. I don't know how. Because I've never figured that out. Maybe it's only select one Grim. No? Well, let's see. Alright. Alright, this summons Grimms. Select all Grimms. How to make Grimms walk. Alright, give me a second before I rage quit. I'm curious now. Okay, so apparently, I can control the Grimms with a controller. You know what? At this point, I will honestly take it. I am okay with this. Alright. Relinquish control. I will take it. Honest. That seems to be the foreman's office. Let's go talk to him. Hey, who are you? My name is Phobin. Are you the foreman? I am. You came here to rescue me? Well, not really. I came to shut down this power plant. By the way, how is that the robots haven't already come in and brutally killed you? The door was open. The robots are programmed so they can't enter a place they haven't been invited to. Like vampires, wow. Are they robot vampires then? But they deleted the three laws of robotics, but they couldn't delete the program that wouldn't let them come into a room. Okay. No, kid, they're just regular robots. Robot vampires don't exist. What kind of world do you think we live in? One with zombies, Grimms, and little blue talking clouds in it. I was about to say the same. Okay, very smart, but hey, you said you want to shut down the station? Why? I'm helping a friend to retrieve something stolen by Chuck Hogan. Man, I hate Hogan. He forced me to take this job. If you want me to give you a hand, you can count on it. That was easy. Yes, please. You can cause an electrical surge in the station by activating the energy pillars in a specific order. What order? Not so fast, kid. Let's make a deal. If you get rid of the robot leading the strike, I'll tell you how to activate the pillars. You punks are all about altruism, aren't you? Take it or leave it, kid. Okay, I'll think about it. You're gonna take it. I mean, you have no choice. I mean, you literally have no choice. Like, that is how the game is gonna work. Alright. So, whoa. That was way too fast. Excuse you! Give me your mana. Give me this mana. This is health too. Oh! Cool, he's dead. Sweet. That wasn't the leader? I suppose not. My grams, they're gonna die, so let's get rid of them. The scorpions are cool looking. My mana! Yeah! Did my Grims die? They probably did. Wasn't there something they said about Grims not being good against robots? Meh. Stop! Why do you keep respawning? There's nothing up here! Where do you come from? Ow! No! Fuck! If I don't go up there, no one's gonna spawn. Also, I decided since this is a very long game and I get... I have mixed feelings about this game. I'm not in love with it, but sometimes it's fun, sometimes it's just overly frustrating. But, I figure I'm gonna push the episodes to an hour. It's probably not a wise idea, but honestly, it'll get me through it faster. This is apparently a very long game. It's like a 40-hour game. So, I don't know how true that is. It's just looking at, like, the play times on Steam. Oh, shit. Shit! At least I saved. So... I'm just gonna not go, you know, I'm just gonna try and get through it. Do you mind? I'm gonna die. Why? Fucking died again, man. Alright, hold on. Alright. Put that there. I don't know where you guys came from. There's one. There's two. I got no mana. Excuse me, pardon me. Wish there was a way to upgrade your mana. Alright, done. You can just go. Alright. We gotta go this way. Face the robot boss. This is gonna be horrible. Hey, who are you? My name is Tobin. Are you the robot leader? I am, yes. You must be the union representative we asked for, right? Well, this has gone too far. The foreman doesn't know how to properly organize a robot workforce. He's wasting our potential. So you've been rioting because you want to work more. Thanks. Finally, a human who understands robots. Now please, can you get rid of the foreman? I'd annihilate him myself, but I can't walk into his room. I'm not sure killing someone is among my duties as a union representative. That's a shame. Anyway, can we make some kind of deal then? Why not? Everybody loves making deals here in the desert. Great, listen, you look like someone who can do magic. What if I taught you how to summon a robot grim? That's not something we robots usually share with human wizards. A robot grim? Well, that sounds interesting. Let me think about it. Okay, so now who do you want to go with? The foreman or the robot leader? What do you think? I don't know. Both of them look crazy as shit. The foreman can show us the exact sequence to activate the energy pillars. But on the other hand, Techno Rangers are still chasing us, and I can use a grim robot to protect myself. Maybe I can figure out the sequence on my own. So do you help the foreman? No, I want the grim. Screw this, I really want that robot grim. Let's teach that lazy foreman a lesson. I don't know why he's lazy, but... Alright, go finish off that hateful foreman. Yo! Call off your robots! Jesus! Walk in. Alright, let's go. This is probably a bad idea. But we're doing it. Hey, what are you doing? Those damn robots brainwashed you. Yo! Oh, cool. And this mana. I'm stunned! This game. Why is this game so hard? No, honestly, why is it so hard? I literally don't see any... strategy beyond kite and click. Kite and click. Stop hitting me. Stop it! I don't know who they're attacking. What the fuck? I'm just gonna stand here. Oh yeah, let's just throw in random fucking spawning bullshit. Why not? Alright, they leave. Bam. Bam. Ba-bam. I don't know what this mud pit does, but it's doing it. Bam. I apparently can't attack until I come here. Don't touch me. Do not. Don't fucking touch me. Stop! You can do that from anywhere? Okay, let me go. Let me go! I'm gonna fucking die. Die! Fuck you! Jesus Christmas. Yeah, okay. I'm angry. Now I'm really angry. I couldn't even save and heal! I'm dead. I'm fucking dead. Alright, at least I saved after I beat the guy. Jesus Christmas. Alright. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. I wanted to stop playing this game. I'm seriously... I'm invested in the story a little bit. Let's go talk to robot leader. The foreman won't bother you anymore. You sure? I got rid of him. Those were your exact words, weren't they? Now the station is all yours. Okay, you're right. Let me show you how a robot Grim can be summoned then. Yay. Now let's figure out how to cause an electrical surge. Because this is how power plants work. Yep. Mm-hmm. Alright, Foom, are you going to hold my hand for this one too? Alright, so... Alright. I wanted to stop playing this. The battle system is frustrating as fuck. The control system is frustrating as fuck. The puzzles are pointless. Like, The puzzles are not challenging. Nihilumbra, the puzzles were challenging, and you got... But they were doable. And once you... I'm going the wrong way. Once you finish them, it felt like an accomplishment. You felt like you did something. These puzzles are literally step on the buttons. Figure out how to control your fucking Grims so you can step on the... I'm dead. Alright. So... Yeah, here we go again. Use the Grims to step on your fucking buttons. You know what? Actually, you know what? Select all. Just get rid of them. Alright. Red, blue, green, blue, red. Alright, this blue is already pressed down. And I have no choice. That blue is already pressed down, and I have no choice. So let's see if I can't do all blue. Oh, here. Green, blue, red. Oh, okay. Oh, yay. Yay. Thank you. Thank you for this. I really appreciate this. Why are the robots still coming after me when I teamed up with the fucking robots? Oh, look, a scroll. Okay, cool. So, that's blue. That's blue. That's blue. Blue goes to red. So let's see what happens when blue goes to blue. I have to get rid of my Grims because they're going to step on all my buttons and fuck me up. This one? It worked. Okay. This was a good puzzle. I was bitching about the wrong thing. But I'm just saying, like... Okay. I feel like this literally did nothing, but okay, I solved the puzzle. The other ones, like the tic-tac-toe, he literally did not even try. There's a way to win tic-tac-toe as long as you go first. Don't spawn anyone. Just don't. Fuck you! I just wanted to go and save and go back to my bench. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna fucking die. This is what I'm saying. This fucking game. This fucking game. And like, they gave it to me for free. like, they're being so nice. They're promoting my channel. Beautiful Games. They're being wonderful, wonderful people. So, I'm trying to get through this game. I am trying very hard to enjoy this enough to finish this game. Alright, I saved. Oh, I don't even know where you came from. Okay. The tic-tac-toe was bullshit. Like, honestly, he didn't even try. I don't know why I cannot control the Grimms correctly. I don't know why I have to grab the fucking controller to make the Grimms walk somewhere. I don't get it. I should keep playing the game because it was given to me. I was given an opportunity. They're being wonderful about it. And, you know, the least I could do is finish the game and put it on my channel. But I'm also having this problem where if I keep playing the game, I'm just gonna bitch about it. Like, yes, I'm invested in the story, but how much punishment do I have to go through to finish this game? And I very simply, you know, decided for myself I would not play games if I wasn't having fun. Because I've tried a million things in my life. I'm 30 years old. I've tried a million things. I've gone to college. I tried opening a Etsy store for crafts. I've tried to do a lot of things. And in the end, I kept pushing, even when I wasn't enjoying it. And I became miserable. And then I just completely burnt out. And then, like, and then I don't want to do it anymore. So, why, with this, where I'm genuinely enjoying it, I'm treating it like a job. Like, I wake up almost every morning on the weekdays. I either record or I edit. I do something. Like, yes, I make my own hours. Yes, like, I'm playing video games, but I edit. I make my thumbnails. I network. I am trying. Like, no, I don't do YouTube professionally, but yes, I would like to one day make maybe a little bit of money out of it. Because I don't have any income. And going this way. But I'm not gonna keep at it if I'm not having fun. And I'm very, very sorry to the creators of this. I'm very, very sorry to Beautifun Games, but I'm not having fun playing this game. And I don't know how good of an endorsement that is. It's not. I mean, all press is good press, right? But I don't know. Maybe it gets better. Maybe I get some spells that make it better. I feel like I need a more powerful spell. This is all like defense and repelling shit. I don't know. How's it going, Phobin? I did my homework. Really? Everything I told you? You're the best. Let's continue with the plan then. You go to Chunk Hogan's fortress. I'll set fire to the tower, and as soon as Hogan and his men head out to see what's going on, you break in. Look for Hogan's vault, and then use the EMP beacon to open it. And once I open it, how will I know what I have to take from it? How will I recognize your stuff? Just take everything you find in it. Anything that doesn't belong to me, you'll give back to its owners. You'll be doing a good deed, Phobin. Your name will be remembered here at Camp Miller. She's gonna screw us over so bad. Alright, magic compass, tell me where I need to go. This is gonna be so bad. Is that half a couch? Like, little details about this game I love. I love the music. I love it. Like, the 80s feel is there. What? Fire, fire. The electricity tower is burning. Fire, fire. Wow, you are some dominatrix guy. The tower is burning. The one that powers the city. I know that. I'm not deaf. Who did it? I don't know. If it's a Techno Ranger attack, I'll show them not to mess with a punk leader. Come with me and tell your men to come too. Okay. Let's put this EMP to work. Oh, okay. That was easy. There's nothing in here. My health and mana have increased. Thank you. I appreciate that. I don't know where I'm supposed to go. I don't... Ah! Why? So... Really? I don't know. I'm gonna push on. I'm hoping it gets better. And honestly, like, we found a key. Cool. That's nice. Another thing I don't like about this game is the hand-holding. Like, what the fuck? Every 5 seconds, Foom pops out and is like, we need to do this, we need to do that. And, like, this obviously is not for children. They swear. Foom swore. Foom said shit. Like, so why the hand-holding? I'm an adult. I can figure shit out. And... I don't know. But, yeah. We found another key. Now we can get in. Okay, I don't even know where I'm supposed to go. I'm just, like, wandering in circles. Oh. This big gaping maw thing, huh? Let's get inside. Okay. I'm sorry, it doesn't look like a door. It just looks like decoration. That's weird. Why? Lucy said she's a craftswoman, but I expected other kinds of things. The only thing here is a bat full of spikes. What are you doing with my scepter? See, like, the game makes me laugh. This is my power scepter. Drop it right now or you die. I don't like being threatened. I don't like being robbed. So you know what? I don't care if you drop it or not. I'll kill you anyway. Ah! Alright, time to homestuck this bitch. I don't know why this reminds me of this. I am Foborn! What? You damn kid, what kind of grim are you? I'm not a grim, I'm a dark wizard made of pure neon magic. Also, I'm the last thing you'll ever see in your poor miserable life. Hogan. Chunk Hogan. Okay. I thought I put a new spell up there, but I guess not. Stop it! This is pretty hilarious that this guy is easier than the other guy I fought. Like, stop grabbing me! That is some bullshit. Done. He's down. Yeah, that was a lot easier than the other guy because I had Foom doing the thing. I almost died, but still. Now I can learn a new spell. Sweet. And she just waltzes right in. She's got no problem waltzing right in. Wow, guys, what was that? We actually don't know yet. It was so freaking awesome. Oh, I see you opened the vault. Yes, but we only found a bat with spikes. Hogan called it his power scepter. I know, that's exactly what I was looking for. You've been so helpful that I must tell you the truth, but please don't get mad at me. Don't turn that into that Phoban thing again. Phoborn thing again. What's going on? This is Camp Miller's power scepter. Anyone who holds it rules over this camp. Vertebrae, the leader of the Great Punk Nation, sent me here to annex Camp Miller to his territories. Hogan knew, and that's why he didn't allow me into the camp. But now, thanks to you, Vertebrae has a new camp under his command. You lied to me. You used me. No shit, dude. No shit. I'm so sorry, kid. I couldn't trust a punk to do this job, but I thought a non-punk guy like you wouldn't give a damn about the Great Punk Nation. And you were right. I had way more important things to do. I stopped to help a poor crosswoman, not a military leader. I owe you a favor. Remember to look for me anytime you need it. No thanks. I'll be happy if I don't see you ever again. Phoborn. I have to tell the dragon about this. Oh, stuff is happening. See, like... Oh, hey. Okay, here we go. Ah! Man, decoding this book is going to finish me. Why is the book exploding? But I must go on. I'm getting closer. Let's try again. Ah! Also... Whatever. Damn. Just one more time. You're gonna kill yourself. Chapter 4, Rokubik and the Lost Memories. Okay. I am a camp conqueror, apparently. So yeah, I don't know. Maybe it'll get better. Maybe it'll get worse. Who knows? Alright, let's summon my guys here. I don't have my magic compass. Fuck you! That's another thing, like, I don't know, I feel like, I'm used to RPGs where, stop spawning enemies! Where you kill enemies, you get experience. And like, you do get items to like help with spells and everything, but the spells... Everything's scripted. Getting the spells is scripted. Getting the power-ups is scripted. Being able to merge with Foom. Where are all these guys coming from? Is scripted. I have no mana. And like, that's another thing. Like the mana constantly running out. Ugh, I died. I fucking died. Like, it's, yeah, you can go up and get more mana from the guy by pressing F, but, oh, by the way, you have no way to heal yourself. Can I have a healing spell? I would love a healing spell. So you're just stuck running away and kiting. And apparently these guys, like, are ranged, so fuck that. Like, everyone has a ranged attack. Okay, I'm full up on health. Alright, cool. I'm guessing I'm going the right way. Yo! You got fucking guns, man! Like, I can't even take cover. Because if I run, more enemies spawn. I just... If I got experience from this, at least I'd be leveling up. At least I'd be getting stronger. But no, it's just an endless fucking horde that slowly whittles me down. Am I supposed to run? Like, am I supposed to just book it? I'm gonna book it. Okay, let's book it. Let's fucking book it. It's a bridge. I see that. The bridge is already repaired. If you call it a repair, but it will do the job. Let's see the professor. Whatever. Alright. I guess I'm supposed to fucking book it. I don't know. That goes against every video game that I've ever played. Like, unless it's like a stealth thing. Heal me, please. I don't even know. Hi, dude. I want your treasure chest. You have nothing in there. Thanks. There's so much frustration going on. Oh, Damon! Hi, Phobin. Wait, where are you? That doesn't look like the library. I'm in Mudtown. What? Why? That's not what I told you to do. I know, but the library wasn't a safe place anymore. You crossed the desert, the wastelands, that's a dangerous place. No shit, I died 5 million times. On the contrary, I made a lot of new friends. That's what I think of that. That's not funny, Phobin. You put yourself in danger. Don't treat me like a child. I can take care of myself. And I told you, staying at the library was no longer an option. Here in Mudtown, I hope to find Professor Ben Rokovic, the guy who wrote that history book about magic. He might know where the first altar is. I don't know if that's a good idea. This whole mess is my fault. I had to do something to solve it. I still think you should be hiding somewhere instead of wandering around, but I guess I can't force you. Meanwhile, I'm taking advantage of my new status as an order student to get some decoding spells. That's gonna be really fucking suspicious. Are you okay, Damon? You look, I don't know, haggard. I feel a bit tired, yes. The decoding spells demand a lot of energy, even from experienced wizards, and I'm just a rookie. Stop using them, then. You'll get ill. I can continue this quest by myself. No, time is crucial. Who knows when Merklin will find you. Okay, but be careful. You too, brother. You too. Damon's gonna fucking die. Okay, let's look for information about Professor... Sorry for talking to... Yeah, thank you. Thank you for the hand-holding. Let's talk to this dude. Oh, hi. Welcome to Mudtown, birth of the Supreme Warlock of the Order. Biggest cheddar cheese in the world. See? That's interesting. Is he riding a four-headed serpent? I guess so. Like, I suppose they wouldn't make it his cock. Mudtown University. The university doesn't exist anymore. They moved down because of, you know, the mud. It was bad for the books, it seems. Oh no, good old Yoko Rogabook still lives in town. To the southeast, the House Rally Electronic. Yeah. You're welcome. Thank you. Now it's saved. Okay, so this is Mudtown. Where's the mud? It looks paved. Like, I guess the mud is flying through the air? I don't know. Let's talk to this guy with his nice pants. If you came to see the giant cheddar cheese display to City Hall, I'm sorry you can't right now. The mayor is holding an emergency meeting about the zombie attacks. I wanted to see the cheese, but okay. Gonna break your shit. Gonna save my shit. And we're gonna go in here. Hello! Hello, are you Professor Bren Rokovic? Yes, I am. Who wants to know? My name is... Oh, but what am I seeing? The Magna Fatum himself, here in front of me. I hadn't heard that name in my whole life before, and now everybody calls me that. And it can talk. Amazing. Did you teach it to do so, kid? Teach me to speak? Him? Don't make a laugh. I could already recite Beowulf when this guy was still pooping his diapers. They were... Oh, no, because his dad had the staff. And you're funny. This is incredible. I have no words. The Magna Fatum in my own home. And who are you, kid? Why are you and the Magna Fatum traveling together? My name is Phobin. Foom and I are looking for the first altar and thought you could give us a clue as to where it is. The first altar. So I reckon you know about the mega magic spell, too. Yes, we also know casting it would kill Foom, and we want to prevent that from happening. Well, Would you follow me, please? There are conversations that must be had underground. I don't know. Your house looks pretty private. That is a badass statuette. I want that. He has my lion. Oh, what's this? Summon population has increased. I will take it. I just made all those adjustments. Let's go downstairs. Cool basement, bro. We are safe to talk now. Here in my bunker, the Order's ears can't reach us. So, do you know where the first altar is? I don't. But I know another way to protect you, your friend. Exposing Merklin as the evil man he really is. Bytes and bytes of compromising information which could get Merklin deposed are stored inside a computer called the Beta 6. Ooh, I like that. But I feel like we get rid of Merklin, another person's gonna appear and it's just gonna be awful. I built it a long time ago when I realized that some of the data I had compiled through my years as a professor were full of inconsistencies and contradictions. It was like someone had been messing with the knowledge I gathered, altering it in strange ways. I started wondering if it had something to do with that urban legend about the erasers. The what? The erasers, they are a myth, an old wives' tale. Some people believe these ghostly creatures can erase a person from reality. And by erase, I don't mean just killing that person off, but eradicating each and every memory of them. Any vestige of their existence is instantly wiped out. The horrific truth is, they are not a superstition. The erasers do exist! What? And how can you know that? As I told you, I built that computer, the Beta 6. I designed it to search for deleted memories in my own brain. After many attempts, I was finally able to recover and save onto the computer a lot of facts that had once been in my mind and then were taken away from me. A huge number of those lost memories had to do with the Order. There's a lot of typos in this. Merklin schemes to increase its power and the existence of the erasers. Unless the erasers are making the typos. Despite not being able to actually control them, Merklin managed to use the erasers to get rid of his rivals. Where is the Beta 6 computer? I used to keep it at home, but rumors reached the Order that someone had built a machine to detect erased memories. I then hid it in a place they never looked, one of their own temples. I chose the desert temple where I studied as a kid. I don't think that's a good idea. Sorry, Yorick, Jesus. My intention was to keep it there for a few years, to be sure the Beta 6 would collect enough information to expose Merklin's machinations. That was before the temple was abandoned when a mysterious fire creature attacked it. Now I'm old and going there to retrieve the Beta 6 is too much for my rusted bones. We can go there for you. All that information would be priceless. The Beta 6 is hidden within the temple. If you're going to go there, let me give you this. Give me shit. Look at those giant floppies. Oh my god, he just grabbed them. Oh my god. Oh, that thing's 3.5 inch. Aww. Those aren't the really big ones. I wanted the really big, actually floppy disks. Come on, guys. The Beta 6 has been in that temple for decades. If you think removing it from its hideout might damage it, use these disks to save the data instead. Oh, and one more thing. Oh my god, what am I yawning? You'll probably find a priest guarding the door to the temple. Guard priests are always loyal to their jobs, even if the temple they guard is derelict. You're telling me! If you ask for a code word, say Fratelli. It's an old one, but I hope it'll work. Thanks! Thank you, kid. If everything goes right, Merklin's time will soon be over. Alright. Alright, we're getting somewhere. See, I like the plot. So, I guess I'll keep pushing on. I don't know, should we go to the temple? Let's go to the temple. And then I'll end it. Another save. Yeah. Alright, temple time. Hopefully. God, I'm just falling apart today. Alright. Do we have to cross the bridge? We have to cross the bridge. Alright. I'm gonna try one of these. And I'm gonna try one of these. Oh! We'll try two of those. I forgot I have three Grimms now. That's a good thing, at least. More Grimms, more damage. Maybe I won't be so mad anymore. Where did all these things come from? Help me! Help me! Oh, my Grimm's died. Bam. Bam. Okay. I'm gonna get rid of you, and get rid of you, summon you, alright. Can I sneak through here? No. Alright, so we gotta, fuck me! I don't know, should I run for it again? I feel like if I run for it, it's gonna be bad times. Yes. Apparently this is something. Alright. Oh, there's wind. That's kind of neat. Another save point. I will take it because this game is brutal. Alright, the Exegrims are helping. So, I'm not going to complain about that. I do like the Exegrim. So, I got some buddies. Fuck! I don't want to go too far because it'll just spawn more enemies. If I go up here, I'm trying to think now. Where did I save? Is it over here? Yeah, this will heal everyone. Maybe I can get them to level up. Excuse you. The problem is... Oh good, one did level up. Sweet. Hello, I am here. Hi man. Stop there, you need a code word to enter this place. Yes, yes, I know, Fratelli. Well, that's an old one. A very old one, but it's correct nonetheless. You're free to go inside. Thanks. You really deserve every cent they pay you for your work. Pay? Don't insult me, kid. A guard priest doesn't work for money. He works for fulfillment. Good for you. I wish I could pay with fulfillment at the mall. Ha 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 ha. Your life must be sad. Alright. I think we're about to call it. Yep. Alright, so I'm gonna leave this here. I'm just gonna... tap this. Alright. I'm sorry for all my bitching, but I don't know. I don't know how to feel about this game, but I'm gonna keep pushing on. I'm gonna keep pushing. I'm gonna do longer episodes to try and get further so it doesn't get as drawn out. And really, like, I'm sorry for all my bitching, but thank you, Beautifun Games, for giving this to me. For giving me the chance to play it, for promoting me. Like, I don't deserve it. And I'm sure your game doesn't deserve the shit that I'm giving it. But I just suck. So, thank you everyone so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I will see you in the next one. Bye!